Welcome team.
Welcome to the API testing with Postman tool demonstration session by MindMagic's team. I have close to 16 plus years of experience in the software testing industry, and I call myself as a full stack QA engineer, wherein, you know, I'm pretty much an expert in all areas of software testing, such as the manual testing, the mobile apps testing, API testing using Postman tool and other tools such as SOAP UI tool, Postman tool, Catalan Studio, Insomnia tool, Tailend tool. Of course, there are so many other tools out in the market, and I do a lot of training programs on API testing using different tools depending upon the participant's interest and job requirement. And apart from this, I do performance testing using JMeter, security testing using Burp Suite, Zap tool, Wookie tool, and a lot of other open source tools. Now, coming to my experience, right? So I've been working for close to 17 years in this IT industry. I worked in Bangalore for almost 10 years, and now I have relocated to Hyderabad in the last 8 years. I've been working here for different organizations on consulting assignments, projects, and training programs, both online training programs as well as classroom training programs. And so far, I had delivered close to, I would say, 80 plus batches across the industry. And there are nothing less than 1,000 plus participants who benefited by taking courses from me, either through online mode or classroom mode. And most of the times I try to project myself as an entertainment plus trainer, which becomes an entertainer, right? So that's how my teaching style would be more focused on. And my focus would be more on setting up the foundations very strong for any participant, so that once the basics and the foundations or the essentials are clear in our mind, the understanding of the tool becomes pretty much easier. So we are going to start our training program only from the roots, and then we scale up to the heights in terms of understanding API testing using Postman. Coming to the course curriculum, API testing using Postman tool. So let me quickly show you the overview of the tool content that I had prepared. So this is the course curriculum for API testing using Postman tool. And trust me, this is the industry standard course content we have prepared, keeping in mind the expectations of any organization, the expectations of the participants, the expectations of the customers. And keeping that in my mind, I had prepared this course because I myself is working on a couple of API testing projects, API automation projects, and I know the challenges faced by the regular test engineers. So all those challenges are converted into some chapters in our course program. But towards the end of this course, there is also a small quick assessment or an assignment that MindMagic does, which is 20 multiple choice questions. Once you go through this examination, you will clearly understand where you stand and how course has taught you different things. Now this course is for close to 20 hours to 24 hours or some 18 hours, I would say, on the rough. And sometimes when the participants have got questions, of course, the course duration also extends, right? Sometimes I cater one dedicated session only for the Q&A. And we can have this training on a daily basis, 1 hour per day or 2 hours per day. We can do this program either on weekdays or on weekends, depending on the participants' interest and availability. Now, these are the four business objectives that I have written here. So this is the objective of the training program. The very first business objective, if you look at it, you will get complete knowledge on the REST APIs and the SOAP APIs. So not just the practical execution, the theoretical understanding and practical understanding of the APIs concept, REST APIs or RESTful APIs and SOAP APIs. You will get a thorough knowledge on the concept of APIs, the types of APIs, that is REST APIs and SOAP APIs will be shown to you guys. How do we automate these REST APIs and SOAP APIs using Postman tool? That's my second business objective by giving some examples. Of course, these examples will be real time. I can take multiple number of examples. The more number of questions you ask me, the more examples I can take up in the session as well. This is my second objective and third objective together. And the fourth objective is, how do we generate a fantastic HTML test report which is shareable to my customers, to my managers, to my developers? So that's my fourth business objective. Now, in this particular demonstration class, I will show you the business objective four. How do we generate? I may not be explaining that in a very detailed manner because there are so many things that we have to learn to achieve business objective four, but I'll show you quickly how easy it is. So you will at least see that practically during this demonstration. I have described this entire course curriculum in the form of chapters, just like any subject, any textbook, right? So I have created this in the form of chapters. Chapter one is course introduction, which essentially is this class that we are having today, a demonstration class. Chapter two is introduction towards the APIs and the web application architecture. Now this is a theoretical concept which will last for at least 2 days, and very interesting concept. Because in my experience with most of the participants whom I trained, everyone said they benefited a lot from Chapter 2 because they are not aware of these simple concepts. And that will help us to understand the actual API testing concepts as well in a very rooted fashion. It's not that you are saying just because you know it. You have a reason why you are saying you know something. So that's my intention of Chapter 2. So in Chapter 2, we are going to talk about introduction to the web application architecture. We are going to talk about the client and server model, the different protocols, namely HTTP and HTTPS protocols for API testing. Of course, there are other protocols such as FTP, MQTT, SQL, file protocol, and so on. But we are not using those protocols because the API's concept is mostly restricted to HTTP protocol and HTTPS protocol, which stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. Now, we are also going to talk about the security-related protocols, which is SSL and TLS protocols. SSL stands for Secure Socket Layer. TLS stands for Transport Layer Security. Now, whenever a client and server establish a connection, that's when a handshake happens. There are two types of handshakes, SSL handshake and a TLS handshake. So we are going to talk about this handshake process in depth during our actual day two onwards, I mean once you enroll for the course. So we're also going to talk about the request headers, response headers, the cookies, the HTTP methods, which otherwise are called as HTTP words. Then we are going to talk about a couple of HTTP methods, which are safe and unsafe. We are going to talk about these methods, get, post, put, patch, and delete. Then we'll jump on to introduction to APIs. And then we are going to talk about where does an API reside. Of course, the answer is a middleware layer, the intelligence layer or the business layer. We are going to see that in a diagrammatical fashion and understand where exactly this resides. And then the architecture of APIs, or maybe I can say the types of APIs available, web services available. So you have REST API, SOAP API available in the market. Chapter 3 focuses on API testing. So how do we test APIs? What are the advantages of testing APIs? What are the disadvantages if you don't test the APIs? And what are the different testing techniques involved in API testing? In a regular manual testing, we all say, you know, hey, I have done smoke testing. I have done regression testing. We are doing retesting. Now we are doing system testing. Similarly, we have a lot of testing techniques in API testing as well. Now, just to name a few, we have load testing of APIs, performance testing of APIs, or security testing of APIs. We have, of course, positive testing and negative testing. We have memory buffer overflow testing, HTTP method validation testing, and so on. So all these things will be described in Chapter 3. And of course, we are going to talk about the syntax of an API. How does an API look like? I mean, from a syntax perspective, from an example perspective, how does it look like? We are going to talk about that in Chapter 3. And there are so many tools in the market, right? So why did we choose Postman? So that's a topic we are going to talk about in the course as well. And why do we use Postman for API testing? Why not any other tool? So this is a continuation to my previous point. And then Chapter 4 is, we are jumping on to Postman tool. So Chapter 4 gives us a complete real estate understanding of Postman graphical user interface. So I have the Postman tool open here, which you can see here. So here I'm going to focus on how do we understand this area? What is collections? What is history? What is new? What is import, runner, this dropdown, the workspaces, the launchpad, how do I invite you to my Postman workspaces? And there are some settings over here. There is some environment over here. There is a footer bar here, right? So we are going to learn all these things, which is my GUI real estate understanding in this particular chapter. So that's what my Chapter 4 talks about. Chapter 5 is introduction to another tool called as Whistler tool, which is specially designed for SOAP APIs testing. So this is a bonus for our course. So I'm going to talk about another tool as well called as Whistler, with the help of which we can test the SOAP APIs. And after that, we will learn how do we test the same APIs using Postman tool as well. So Chapter 5 is a bonus that we are going to talk about. And these are the different topics that I'm going to teach about Whistler tool. And one of the common tools in the market, a famous tool. But trust me, most of the API test engineers are not even aware of this Whistler tool, but every developer uses this. So there you can become very close to a developer as well. And Chapter 6 focuses on Postman workspaces. So there are different workspaces available in Postman. Just to name a few, you have a personal workspace and a team workspace. A personal workspace is a one only you have access to. A team workspace is something where your team also has access to a workspace. Right? Maybe just to show you a quick example, I have created this MindMagic team workspace. And if I see here, I can show you the members of my workspace as well. See, I have myself, I have two more guys as well who are members of my workspace. So they can see whatever I do in my Postman work, and I can see whatever they are doing. So it is like a collaboration activity. So Postman workspaces, which is my Chapter 6, focuses on complete understanding of workspaces, and that's my starting step to Postman tool. Then Chapter 7 focuses completely on REST APIs and SOAP APIs testing. From, you know, I'm going to talk about 360 degrees testing of REST APIs and SOAP APIs. So just to name a few, what is that we are going to talk about? Let me read out. So how do I test an API which is secured and which is not secured? When I say secured, it is following HTTPS protocol. When I say unsecured, it is following HTTP protocol. Then we are going to do the same thing for a REST SOAP API as well. And once we test an API, there are different parameters that we are going to validate, such as the response code, response description, the response time, the response size, the cookies received, the authorization, the request headers, the response headers, response body. All these things are going to be tested and validated in Chapter 7. Then we have functional testing of APIs, right? I mean, of course, this is where we are going to learn positive testing and negative testing. How do we test an API from a positive aspect and from a negative aspect, which is very, very important in the course and in API automation. Then there are certain real estate features of Postman tool, such as history tab. Just like a browser maintains a history, Postman also maintains a history. We are going to learn about that. Then we are going to talk about an authentication model in Postman. So if you have an API and it uses authentication, for the API to be accessed, you need to use a username or a password. So just to show you an example again for this, I have taken an example here. So if you see here, these are few of the APIs in Swagger format. Swagger is another tool with the help of which developers develop the APIs. So this is one example of a Swagger tool or a Swagger format. So this is one of my API which is following get method. How do we test this kind of APIs? So if I just try it right away on this, so I'm passing some username and password. Only when I pass my username and password and click on execute, I do get my answer from the server. Here, this is the API that you have. Now, if I test this API directly on my, the password here is incorrect, so let me type in the correct password. See, now I got a response body and I have got the response code as 200, which means successful. So, if I try it without a password, okay, which means I'm not getting authorized myself, then I have got a 404 error. And the error is that, of course, we understand that this error is because the password is not entered. So, how do we test these kind of APIs on the Postman tool? So I have different authentication methods here available. We are going to touch base all these authentication methods in the course. To name a few, we are going to talk about basic authentication, digest authentication, access status. Then we are going to talk about how do we test an API that returns a JSON document or an XML document or a HTML document or an image document or a regular document. And of course, we are going to talk about what are cookies and how do we understand cookies. Now, most of the people assume that they know cookies, but I will talk about something interesting about cookies and their importance in API test. So that's about my Chapter 7. And Chapter 8 focuses on collection. You know, this is my collection. If you see here, these are the collections. So if I just change it to my personal workspace. So this is my personal workspace. And these are two of my collections. So I can show you a REST APIs and SOAP APIs. I can show you some folders here, which has some positive test cases and negative test cases. How do I create it? Of course, this will be taught in the course introduction. Once to come, you'll understand all these things. So all these things are discussed in my collections topic. So this Chapter 8 focuses on how do I create a collection? How do I create a collection for REST APIs and SOAP APIs? And how do I execute all these, 100 APIs together? So collection helps us execute 100 APIs or 50 APIs or 2 APIs together at the same time. Maybe just to show you a quick run, right? So let me click on this and click on run button. Now this opens up collection runner. And this is where I'm going to help you understand how do I do data-driven testing, performance testing, or a regular manual testing or automation testing. Of course, not now in the demonstration, but I'm going to execute all my APIs. And if I click on this run button, I've done all the required settings earlier. Therefore, it's a simple shortcut method as of now. So here you can see the percentage of execution, 55%. And you can see here the APIs are getting executed. So this is the automation I have done already. And you can see some, so 120 has passed and 21 APIs have failed. And if I click on run summary, I can see here tick mark and then cross mark which says which has passed, which has failed. Okay, so we are going to learn all these things in detail in our actual execution process. So if I click on failed, it shows only the failed ones. If I click on the passed ones, I can filter only the passed ones. If I click on this, it shows both passed and failed. So this is my collection runner, which we are going to talk about that in the actual course. Okay, that's my chapter 8. Chapter 9 is about curl commands. Again, this is a bonus topic which we are talking. Curl commands. Curl stands for command line, URL stands for uniform resource replicator. So command line, uniform resource replicator. Most of the developers, when they develop an API, when they enable communication between two different components or modules or softwares, they use these curl commands. And the curl commands are available in different languages. If your developer gives you a curl command, how do you understand it? That will be taught in this lesson. How do you convert curl command into a regular API language? That will be taught in this particular chapter 9. So an example of a curl command, let me show you here. So if I probably go to one of my API, and if I click on code, I can show you the code. So this is the curl command that I had generated. And if my developer used this command, how do I convert this into my actual API? Or how do I convert API into curl command? Those things would be taught in my chapter 9. That's pretty much essential because that will bring you closer to your developer. Then chapter 10 focuses on Postman variables. Any tool has the concept of variables. Postman, of course, is no exception. We also have the concept of variables. There are two types of variables, a global variable and an environment variable. I can just show it quickly over here. So if I click on settings icon, click on globals, here I can see all my global variables if I had created. Since I have not created, I am not seeing it here. If I have to create an environment variables, I can create my environments over here. So I can create an environment here, like this. So I can see a QA environment, and I can see my environment in the dropdown now. So the use of environment, the use of global variables will be taught clearly in my chapter 10, and they have a very big importance in automation testing. Now, chapter 11 focuses on the automation part of APIs. So in the automation part of APIs, there are multiple concepts that we're talking about. One is performance testing. How do I automate it? Two, data-driven testing using CSV files and JSON. We are going to talk about that. And we are going to talk about how do I create some quick API scripts that will test my APIs. So let me just show you some scripts I had already written here. So these are few of the API language, I mean Java scripting scripts I had written. Okay, all these are my scripts I have written. So how do I write all these scripts and how do I test it? So if I send it to server, I'm using Postman tool to test my API. This is one of the API that you see here. And I send it to server. And you can see the response that I've got from the server as well. Okay, see, if you see test results, I can see that what has failed and what has passed. So something else also has failed. And I'm going to debug and troubleshoot it later, of course, in the course explanation. So this is my automation, which we are going to talk about in my API automation part 1. And we're also going to talk about Postman monitoring, which is a very user-friendly feature which helps us to monitor the health of the API on a continuous basis. Once you create a monitor, you schedule it, and every day this monitor runs automatically. Or every, I mean, once in a week it runs, or every 5 minutes you can make it run, and you can see the reports as well. In fact, you can email these reports to your managers or customers directly. Even you can automate the process of email sending as well. That will be taught in my chapter 11. Chapter 12 is my next level of automation, where I'm going to generate my HTML reports or JSON reports. This is something which I'm going to do it practically right now. I'll show it very at a higher level shortly. And of course, there is an assignment towards the end of the course. It will be a subjective assignment and an objective assessment, which I'll pass it on to you guys and you'll understand this. And these are the prerequisites of course. And these prerequisites anyways will be covered in my chapter 2. Okay? Chapter 2 is also my prerequisite, but I thought I'll cover it even if the participants are aware of it. And who should be attending this course? The IT engineers, the software developers, the project managers who want to learn API automation testing, or any manual engineer who wants to shift to API automation field, or even a freshers. Though I have given here three different set of categories or three different people, the way we deliver the course in MindMagic is very unique, and we do it in such a way that everyone can understand the explanation. There is no biasness towards an experienced guy or a fresher. We start at a neutral level. And the concept is to make someone from zero to hero. Okay. And these are the course highlights that we're talking about. This is completely a practical training program. 99% of the training program is practical. 1% of course is theoretical explanations. Because if there is no theory, no one can understand practicals. And of course, I have been training API testing in the last, maybe I would say honestly, 5 years. I've been training this. In a month, I do at least nothing less than 5 different training programs on API testing in a month. 5 different batches is what I do for different organizations, for corporate organizations, online training programs. We also have one-to-one interaction in MindMagic, with the help of which you become an expert. And this is a simple lab setup information I have given, which is something your computer is definitely, you know, abiding with, or your computer definitely matches with this. You need a simple RAM. 8GB RAM is more than enough. And 5 GB hard disk is more than enough. And Postman tool can be downloaded from postman.com website. It's a free tool. Of course, they do have a pay tool, but we can download the free. So this is the agenda which I'm going to talk today for the next few minutes in my demonstration class. Of course, I had already covered the introduction to API testing, right, in the course curriculum. So in API testing introduction, most of the people have this question, right? Where exactly the APIs are developed? And the answer is, in the business layer, the APIs are developed. So a presentation layer is the graphical user interface that you see, I see with my eyes. The storage layer is the database where your database is present. And in between the presentation layer and database layer, there is another layer which is called as business layer. That's where the APIs are developed and consumed. We are going to talk about more about this topic in the course. And this is a simple example of how the APIs will be communicated. So you might be accessing an application from an Android tablet or an iPhone tablet, and then from a computer browser, your request goes to the API gateway software. Your API gateway resides in API business layer, and this talks to your database layer. This is at a very rough level, I'm saying again, but we will have a very detailed, clear explanation as well in our actual course. So there is another diagram I have given here. Maybe I'll probably talk about this, okay, so that you'll understand the concept of APIs. Let us say this is you. So you wanted to visit a restaurant and have food. So you visited a restaurant. You are sitting and no one comes forward to you. And then you feel, okay, let me walk to the kitchen and then ask him, hey, can I have a burger? And imagine that the guy who is sitting in the kitchen cannot understand English. He's from another country who don't understand English. He probably speaks Portuguese language or Japanese language or probably some other language. And you don't understand their language. He does not understand your English language. So you have this problem of communicating your order to him. And finally, after some repeated attempts, you tell him that this is what you're looking forward for, and he gives you the order to come back. And then you will wait for a few more minutes to see if someone else can come and ask you for the bill or for the check, or probably to check if you wanted to have something else as well for food. No one comes and you feel very unhappy. You go yourself to the counter, make the payment, push off for the day. The next day you feel hungry. You will not come to the same restaurant because you have a bad experience. You probably will turn to a different restaurant. And when you go to the next restaurant and sit on the table, immediately this waiter comes to you and says, good morning, ma'am. How can I help today? What can I serve you? Now you feel very happy because someone is talking in English and someone greeted you and someone wanted to bring something to you for eating from the kitchen. So you tell him that, hey, I'm looking for some potato wedges or a potato burger. And this guy says, okay, we have it and we'll bring it. So this guy goes to the kitchen and he brings the order to you. After you're done with the eating, he might come and say, hey, this is the bill. Do you want to pay the bill or you want to have some more food? And you say, okay, I want to pay the bill. So you pay the money to the waiter and then you go for the day. Now your experience with restaurant 2 is pretty happy as compared to restaurant 1, right? So in the restaurant 2, you had food. In the restaurant 1 also, you had food. But you had some difficulty in getting the food in the first restaurant. Whereas in the second restaurant, you got the same tasty food similar to restaurant 1, but there is some better user experience. You are getting food with the help of one waiter who helped you. Similarly, in software applications terminology, this waiter is my API, application programming interface. Okay, API stands for application programming interface. So what is an API? There is module 1 here and there is module 2 here. Module 2 is developed in Java. Module 1 is developed in, let's say, Python. So let us say for some business reason, these two modules have to communicate with each other. But how do they communicate? Because they are two different modules, they are developed in different languages. Then you need a waiter or an API in between. So this API enables communication between module 1 and module 2. Maybe tomorrow you might have module 3 as well. So if you want module 3 to talk to module 2, again you need an API in between. So this API is a source code or a piece of code that has been developed by your developers that enables communication across multiple components or multiple modules, multiple systems, multiple softwares. Okay? So this is a quick intro about my API testing. I mean about APIs, not even API testing. So then you might be having this question, right? Did I make a right choice by opting for API testing course? And the answer is of course yes. Now this diagram that you see is a very recent diagram that I took, a recent trend I took from Google Trends. Okay? And this is capturing even the July data. So you can see here, this is talking about till July 14th, and this data is captured from the last 12 months across worldwide. So I'm comparing API testing topic versus manual testing topic. This is what people are searching for in Google, and Google says that more number of people are searching for API testing than for manual testing. You can see here the blue bar indicates API. The red bar indicates the manual testing. Okay, this is from Google Trends. I took this and this is the latest report. So Google clearly says that, not Google, I mean the industry, the human beings who are searching for API testing and manual testing, they are saying that people are searching more for API testing than manual testing. Why? because API testing has become a new norm in the job market. API testing has become a default skill for everyone in the market, right? I mean, it's not a rare skill in the market now. That's something which everyone is expected to learn. If I say that I know only manual testing, the future is very, very less. I mean, the career growth is very limited. You might be replaced tomorrow with a better guy, the junior guy who says, I know API testing. So this is the reason why I wanted to take this screenshot and show it to you. And trust me, this is a true data that is coming from Google Trends. And Google Trends clearly says that API testing is going to stay here for a longer duration. So this is across the planet. So if you look at this, the blue one indicates API testing. The red one indicates the manual testing. If you see here, most of the countries across the world, they're talking more about API testing alone. So if you get into trends.google.com, you can see a similar diagram as well. So I would say, yes, opting for an API testing course is definitely a worth for your career. And coming to the different certifications available on API testing, because there are few organizations which choose some importance to the certifications when you have. Of course, there are few certifications available, and one of the certification names that I have heard of is API Test Professional. So this is one of the name given API Test Professional, and there is an organization called as vSkills. So if you get into vSkills.com, there you have to pay some money to attempt an online examination, and once you pass it, you get this certification, which is valid lifetime. So it says you are a vSkills certified API Test Professional. And there are so many people in the market who are going for this vSkills certification as well. And this is the exam details about the certification. So the duration is 60 minutes. There are 50 questions given, and the pass mark is 25 marks. 50% marks is what you have to secure to get your certificate. And of course, the good thing is there is no negative marking. And there are 70 exam centers in India for vSkills. Now, when you say 70 exam centers, definitely vSkills is a good one in the market. I mean, you can recognize, people can recognize, people can understand the vSkills certificate. And the cost is around $119, or in Indian rupees, it is around 3,500 rupees. So these are the URLs that you can visit to get some information about vSkills certification or another certification, which is API Test Professional. This is from Soap UI or Smart Bear company. So there's a company called as Smart Bear, which is giving this Soap UI certification, and the URL is this. Okay, you can just go through that and you will get some information in case if you are interested in some certification. Now, from the Mind Magic team, when you complete a course with us, we would give you a participation certificate and a completion certificate. I mean, ORS completion certificate that you have successfully completed the course API testing using Postman from Mind Magic. We do this with every participant who joined us and completes the course. This is a topic on which I'm going to talk about the practical execution, right? So HTML test report for API execution. Now, in fact, this is what I was telling you, right? Chapter 12, API Automation Part 2. I said I will do it practically, right? So let me do that right now. So this is my Postman. And, you know, probably I wanted to generate a report for my REST APIs. So what I would do is, I will quickly do a couple of steps here. So I'm generating a public link. Now, you may not understand this right away, but just be with me. You will see the link and the execution right now. So I'm going to my command prompt and I'm going to execute this right now. Okay. Now when I run this command, my HTML extra report will be generated. So I'm actually doing some automation. I have installed all the required framework already on my computer, a tool called as Newman tool, with the help of which, you know, we are going to automate things. Okay, the Newman tool. Now it is still executing. Okay, that's why I don't see anything. I can see the command prompt clearly. Once the report is generated, I can see my command prompt back in action. Yeah, so I didn't see any errors. Now the report will be generated in this part, see users IQT. Let me open that as well. Yeah, so this is the report that is generated now. If you see, this is the timestamp, which is my current timestamp. And if I open this, I can see my nice HTML test report. So here I can see that there are 141 conditions I'm testing. 21 APIs have failed. If you come down, I can see the report here. So I get a nice tabular report. I can share this HTML report with my customer as well, the manager. If I click on total request, I can see all the requests, and the red ones indicate the ones that has failed. So here I can see the test case pass percentage is only 86%. And I can see my request headers, response headers, the response body that I received from the server. And these are my test scripts I had written, my automation scripts, and I can see how many passed, how many failed. The good thing is almost everything has passed, but there are two things that has failed here. I know the reason why they have failed, and we will talk about the debugging exercise later. So here, there are reasons why it has failed. Okay? And you can expand the folder as well and see each API and their execution percentage. Here I can see pass percentage is 100. So here also I can see per API what are the test scripts I have written and how the report is showing. Okay, and you can expand the folders, you can collapse the folders using these buttons. And if I go to failed test, I can see all the failed ones in one area. And if I had skipped any test during my execution, I get skip test here. Currently I didn't skip anything, so it says there are no skipped tests. So this is my Newman automation or Postman automation. Now in this Postman automation, I'm going to teach you another tool as well, which is called as Newman. So this is a companion tool or a command line interface tool developed exclusively for Postman tool. And we are also going to talk about Newman tool to generate my HTML extra report. I will show you how do I generate a JSON report or a CLI report right now. Okay, I just remove this command and I execute it. Now you will see that my command is getting executed on the black screen. I mean on the command screen only, I can see my complete API testing report, automation report. So this is for my purpose, I am executing it. In your case, you are executing it for your own purpose. This is like your unit testing. And of course, this cannot be shared with your customer or manager because it is getting printed on your computer only. Okay, so this is the entire report I can print on my command screen. This is called as your JSON report or a command interface report. So this is what I wanted to show you here, some random topic. Of course, you know, I have just shown it how easy it is to use Postman tool, but you might be having a question like, how do I run the command? How do I learn the command? What is the framework I have to set up? All these things will be clearly explained with very good transparency in the actual course once you opt for the course. Okay? And of course, there is a project. I mean, there are different projects that we talk, right? So since this training program is completely practical, right? 99% of the training program is practical. There are different APIs I take, different projects I take. So for the REST APIs, I usually pick up a couple of examples. Let me show you those examples. So for the REST APIs, this is the project we are going to talk about. So here I have multiple APIs. If you see, there are close to 12 different APIs, which we are going to see. So this is something which we are going to learn. We are going to talk about get method, post methods, put method, patch method, delete method. You get the responses for almost everything here. We're going to talk about this entire project. Then my second project is on the authentication examples, where I'm going to take my swagger example. This will be taught clearly. If you still want few more examples, I will take even the different examples in HTTP methods category. This is my project 2. Project 3 is JSON placeholder example. Here also I can try few examples of REST APIs. I can see all the code that are available, all the comments that are available. We are going to talk about all this. And that's about the REST APIs. Now, if I'm talking about SOAP APIs, SOAP APIs have a different format. So this is my important project, which I'm going to talk about, SOAP APIs. So this is a SOAP API project, which is available. We are talking about this. If you still need a few more examples, I have my SOAP API project too. Now, this is useful to help us understand the different weather conditions. Okay. And this is, the first one is used to understand the calculator functionality. So just to show you quickly, you know, that, let me show you that as well. Okay, I think I just lost the application. I have to just see it. I just upgraded the browser, so it got switched somewhere. So if I click on this, my tool is automatically helping me understand what are the APIs available. So this SOAP API document has got these many APIs. So this is the new tool that I was talking about, right? So here I have shown you that I'm going to teach you a bonus topic, which is my Whistler tool, right? This one. So this is my chapter 5 and I'm just showing it quickly here. Okay. So this is how I understand my SOAP API document by using another tool. Similarly, this is another one. So if I go here and click here, I will find my tool here. So these are the APIs available in this particular SOAP project. So we will see how do we test it. So if I click on it, I get the SOAP API definition and how do I test it. We are going to learn all these things in my Whistler tool. concept. So this is project 2 of SOAP APIs, project 1 of SOAP APIs, and 3 projects for REST APIs. Of course, there are so many other projects we can take. Now, in fact, I advise people, you know, why do you want to search something in Google? There is always Postman projects available in API network. So if you have patience, there are 2,375 projects available in Postman alone. You can pick up any project from here. And I will pick up at least one or two projects from here during the course execution, and I will help you understand this. So this also becomes our real-time project execution. So this is about a quick information about projects. And of course, right from day 1 till day 20 or day 16, we are going to talk about all these projects. End to end, we are going to learn. And this is the lab setup information. So your regular computer is more than enough to work on API testing using PostMagic. Okay. So this is a quick download for you guys on the lab setup requirement. And on the additional resources details from MindMagic and from me is, towards the end of the training program, there is an assignment. So one is a subjective assessment where I will ask you guys to write some collections, APIs, and then practice it. And you can talk to me over email or probably during our CAR class if you have any questions. And there is an objective assessment. So this is probably something that helps you in your interviews, with your customers or clients or your job hunting purposes. There are 20 questions I prepared along with answers. So this is an assessment that I'll give it to you guys. This will be your most frequently asked questions in interviews. Then the useful references, I have prepared a testing booklet, which I'm going to share with the participants as well. So this booklet will help you understand the entire thing, right? Maybe let me show you that booklet as well here, right? You can see this screen, right? So this API, MindMagic's API testing booklet. So this is the booklet that I'm going to share with the participants on the last day of the training program so that you will benefit about it. And we can, of course, help you with some resume preparation. MindMagic's team can help you with that. And in case if you want me to send some sample resumes that includes API testing content, I will give it to you. And the resume I'm going to give you will be a different resume which will actually make your profile stand in the market. The resume usually should not be more than, you know, 3 pages to 5 pages. I mean, 5 pages is like only probably for someone with 3 years experience. But the more experience you are gaining, the number of pages in your resume should be shortened. So for my experience, 17 years experience, right, my resume is hardly 2 pages. I should not even have a third page. So I will give you that content, that format, which will help you convert your normal resume to a professional resume. Now in the market, people charge 3,000 rupees to prepare such resumes. But in MindMagic, we do that resumes for all the people who opt for our courses. Not just API testing, any course you opt for, this is something we will help you with. So in case if you have any questions, you can please feel free to talk to MindMagic's team. You can drop an email to support@mindmagics.com and you will get an answer from the MindMagics technical support team. Or you can drop an email to info@mindmagics.com. You have the numbers displayed on the slide at the bottom. You can go through the numbers, talk to them and have a question. If there are any technical questions, maybe we can patch up on a short 5 minutes call, or probably that question will be routed to me by the MindMagics tech support team, and I will be pretty much happy to answer your questions. And in case if you have any feedback for us, please do reach out at info@mindmagics.com, and we would love to work on your feedback. We'll take it constructively and we will see how and what best improvements we can make further to help the participants our training programs and increase the word of mouth for MindMagic's organization. Thank you everyone for this for joining this demonstration. All the very best. Okay, stay safe.